Cherry production.
Hold on! Hey! What? You see it? Unlimited ankle breakers on this 2K! Team me up!
Fuck! I am what I am. What I'm not, see, I never beat. Niggas whooping up until we meet. Catch him like it, put him on TV. And if I sit down, I'm boosting the murder rate. My niggas gon' slide every day. He been talking that shit, I can't beat. So I am what I am.
Oh my god! Oh my god! What's the dealio, man? Jay and Mary back with another video. Now today, I hope y'all all had a blessed one, man. I hope everything was going right at work, at school, whatever the case may be. But we finna get right into it, man. No time to waste. As you guys can see, I was getting my reps up. I was getting my reps up in the Gatorade facility, practicing my dribble moves. But I'll tell y'all, first and foremost, that is not the most important part into ankle breaking. No. First thing I need you guys to do is go to your playmaking badges. Of course, man. You need the playmaking badges to help you, enhance you into getting these ankle breakers. Now, right now, you guys are going to see four different badges that's going to aid you into getting these ankle breakers. Now, they don't do it. No, they don't do it per se, but they'll allow you to do it way easier. You guys got Hyperdrive Quick Chain. These are the ones that make you dribble quick. Next up, you got Quick First Step, which allows you to be unpredictable. You move around to one spot to the other fast as hell. You know what I mean? You need that badge. Handles for Days is important because, yeah, when you're trying to get an ankle breaker, you're gonna run out of stamina. Absolutely. It takes a couple moves sometimes. So, make sure you guys have that Handles for Days on and then Unpluckable. Bruh. What's understood don't need to be explained, man. So, what that leaves me with is 12 badge points. Make sure you guys have at least 12 badge points left so you guys can put the rest of these badges here. You need Ankle Breaker Hall of Fame, obviously, bruh. It's in the title, my nigga. If you ain't know that, bruh, click off the video, bruh. Yeah, not aware. You wasn't really trying to break no ankles. Now, the other thing is Space Creator. Now, this badge right here is so prevalent. It's crazy how many ankle breakers I get right there. When performing a step back move, there's a higher chance of successfully breaking ankles. Yeah, that's all they really trying to say, bro. I got so many ankle breakers straight off of that. Throw that junk on the max tier and watch you rock out, bro. We on right to the next one, gang. Let's get it. Depending on your playstyle and how many ankles you really truly trying to break, I got on Circus 3s. Now, with Takeover, the Takeover I use is called Ankle Breaking Shots, which allows this bash to go even crazy. As you see, when I go into Takeover, my primary Takeover is going to say Ankle Breaking Shots. This allows me to get ankle breakers off of step back, spin moves, anything. You know what I mean? So, when you put on Circus 3s off of an ankle breaker shot like this, it can provide some crazy clips. And then I collab that with Limitless Range. But, we taking them jumps from D. Touch! And the next best thing, obviously, has to be the dribble animations. So I'm about to tell you guys my series right now. The dribble style I'm using is quick. Now, I used to think it didn't matter. No, this matters, man. The quick dribble style allows me to tuck the ball, keep it safe, so I won't be getting plucked when I'm going for them ankles, boy. Now, the next one I got is Kemba Walker size up. Been using this from the beginning of the year. It's so perfect. It's a good setup move. And I'm going to be talking about more setup moves throughout the video, so stay tuned, man. Don't skip. Don't skip nothing. And make sure you guys hit that like and comment. Subscribe as well while we're here. Now, I'm just about to show you guys the rest of the list, and I'm going to scroll all the way down to Kyrie Irving because that is what is the best. The best dribble move on here, bro. The step back is very crucial, and it gets you a lot of space. A lot of ankle breakers y'all gonna see from this. Now, with that being said, we finna get right into this dribble tutorial and the best moves to use when going crazy. We here! Yeah! I'm about to be giving you guys the best moves to use, the most effective ones to use when trying to go for ankles. Now, the first one is this step back right here. Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm gonna be putting clips on the screen. Y'all guys gonna see how effective it is, how many ankles I get from just using this move alone. Now, I'm not gonna do a full dribble tutorial, but I have videos for that. You know what I'm saying? Pop it on the screen. Go to the card. Click on that if y'all wanna learn how to do all these dribbles. But I will show you a quick hand cam of what to do, how to do this move, bro. All you gotta do is flick back on the stick, bro. Hold RT, go one way, and then flick back on the stick and equip that Kyrie Irving step back that I put in the six earlier in this video, man. The next most effective move I've seen is the snatch back right here. You know what I mean? This is the one that gets the most ankle breaker galore. As soon as you activate this move on a standstill person, they go flying, bro. They absolutely go flying, bro. Y'all seen what it look like in the clips, what it look like in the intro, bro. Use this, and I guarantee you, bro, 1 out of 5 times, it's gonna hit. Oh, they gon' drop, bruh. So, use this junk right here, and I'm telling you, this ankle breaker galore as well, dog. The next move is the behind the back. Now, this is the one going side to side. It's almost like the snatchback. It looks very similar, but this time it's leading somebody to the side, and it hit them with a yank. You know what I'm saying? Hit him with a quick Yankee. This move is definitely effective. Not as effective as the last three. And let me tell you guys right now, man. I hope y'all want to skip it through. You can literally break ankles off of any move. You can break them off of hesitation. You can break them off of between the legs. You can break them off anything. These are just the moves that allow you to get the best animations. Now, the last one. Sorry for the course switch where I went idle. You know what I'm saying? I had to cop me a new gym. This is the Jamal Crawford that I talked about. This secret move. Oh my god, this goes crazy. You see, I learned almost how to spam it, bro. I'm a little slow with it still. But I'm telling you guys, you hit somebody with it in the right position. You know what I mean? Pause. Pause. But if you hit somebody at the right time, bro, they're gonna drop, dog. I promise you that. So, with that being said, these are the most effective moves. I'm gonna tell you guys how to use them, though, so you guys can go crazy. Now, I know I threw a few moves at y'all, and y'all just want to go out there and spam it, but please... Please do not do this right here, bro. Do not just run around and just spam a step back, spam a behind the back, and just run. You know what I mean? It's not gonna work. I guarantee you, all you're gonna do is waste shot clock, make your teammates mad, and they not pass you the ball no more because you out here just running around trying to trigger an ankle breaker. Nah, that's not what we finna do, man. And I don't know where Buddy came from, but we gonna let him ride. We gonna let him slide. Look, this is what you wanna do, man. Y'all wanna do setup moves, man. I say use about 2 seconds. 2 seconds of just dribbling in the same place, you know what I'm saying? Mix it up. Pickpocket. Pickpocket is a real thing. So, don't get caught. But you want to dribble in the same place. Set your man up. Make sure that he feels comfortable guarding you, bro. A lot of the times when y'all just try to run around and do the step back, do the behind the back, they're not really in front of you. You want to make sure they're there in front of you. So, when you make separation, 2K deems them in the red zone. And by the red zone, I mean the zone in which somebody can do a move. And 2K says, okay, they can get an ankle breaker. You know what I mean? So, make sure you guys are setting your person up. And I'm about to show you guys gameplay right after this on how to do it, man. You know what I'm saying? Live gameplay of the full game of me just ankle breaking every single play. So, make sure you guys hit that like button, like I said. And we finna do one more tip and get right into this gameplay. Dang. Last tip I want to give you guys is make sure when you guys go to My Health, put on ball handling, bro. Ball handling boost, bro. It only helps. You know what I'm saying? Obviously, you can get ankle breakers without them. But if you want to maximize, enhance yourself getting these ankle breakers, make sure you guys put this ball handling on. And also, like I said earlier in the video, bro, you want to put on handles for days. Why not? Why not put on extra Gatorade boost just to make sure in that 24 shot clock you never get tired? So put on as much Gatorade boost as possible, and that's the last tip. Let go. No, as y'all see, I got a perimeter lockdown on me. But wait, bro, I told y'all what I'm about. Ain't nobody stopping this, dog. So pay attention to every single play, bro. Pay attention to the scoreboard. Every single play, I end up getting an ankle breaker. It got so bad that he ended up fouling out the game because he wanted the ball out of my hand so bad. Look at him. So to start off, you see right here. Oh my God, that's a stun. That's a stun, bro. Now you guys can obviously see. After that stun, I wasn't really even trying to score, bro. It's a lot of times that I let the shot clock go by just hunting out these ankle breakers. This video is strictly to show you guys that it can happen at any time. Any play I want, I can give me an ankle breaker. You know what I mean? So I wasn't really playing a win type shit, but you guys can see my setups, everything like that, how I was setting them up, trying to get him reeled in so I can hit him with that quick, yeah. You know what I'm saying? That quick, yeah, right here. I had to take it, man. I need those. Touch! Give me that. Hey, right here, I did the quick Jamal Crawford that I taught y'all in the earlier part of the video. It's really the setups. It's really the setups that get people reeling right there. You know what I'm saying? Bring it back. Give me another one. I need those ankles, boy. I need them. Holy, bruh. Stop stumbling. Me playing around with this man right here reminds me. Hold on, pause. You know what I'm saying? Hold on, pause. You know, I tried to lay ski 25 lay. Power to 25 lay. But me playing around reminds me of like a gang member, like a gang fight, initiating somebody 8-on-1 and they telling the person that they beating, fight back. You know what I mean? They can't do nothing about it. At this point, I'm just about to show you guys all the rest of the gameplay. You know what I'm saying? I told y'all, look at the scoreboard. Literally, almost every single possession. Mind you, I told y'all, he does foul out at the end. But hold on. Hold on, you know what I mean? Team, yeah. You know when this beat come on, we gotta get right. You know what I mean? Hey, this wasn't an ankle breaker, but it was for sure a cook. Come here, boy. Touch! Hey, yeah. Hey. So many album covers right here. Give me those. God damn. Get on your feet. Get on your feet, boy. What is you doing? Man, I'm telling you, bro. Once you do all this stuff, I can't eat. Once I follow the tutorial, bro, I'm telling y'all, y'all can go absolutely nuts, man. You see this guy. He's having a hard time. He's struggling out here. He fouled out. Like I said, bro, he goddamn fouled out, bro. He reached too much. 5 fouls on that man. I'll be lying to say we won this game, bro. So with that being said, I'm going to catch y'all boys later. I love y'all. I'm out. Bye.